Hello. Today I would like to discuss how we talk, why children born with a cleft palate can struggle to produce normal sounding speech, and what I can do as a cleft speech surgeon to try to get a child to normal speech. I am James Seaward, a pediatric plastic and cleft surgeon at UT Southwestern Medical Center in Dallas, Texas. So let's start with how we talk. Looking inside our superhero here, all speech starts with air being pushed out of our lungs. That air makes its way up through the vocal cords, which resonate to give the air a tone, and then the air arrives in a space behind the nose and mouth. Let's look at this area in more detail. You can see here a face from the side, but if we project our view so we're still looking in the same direction, but now we're looking at the middle of the face, it will look something like this. You can see the nose and mouth at the front. Between these, we have the hard palate, that bony shelf you can feel with your tongue at the top of your mouth. Further back is the soft palate, which has no bone in it but does have muscle, and we'll talk about this more in a minute. Other parts of your face involved with speech are your lips, tongue, and teeth. So let's go back to that air which has been pushed out of the lungs and has resonated through the vocal cords. When it arrives in the space behind the nose and mouth, it can either continue out through the nose or through the mouth. We control which way it goes using the soft palate. Whether or not the soft palate lifts depends on the sound we're trying to make. For most sounds in English, the soft palate lifts up and touches the back of the throat. And this acts as a valve system to stop airflow coming out of the nose. So once this valve is activated, we can build up pressure inside our mouth and use our tongue, lips, and teeth to shape this pressure into the sounds we recognize as speech. If this valve system doesn't work well enough to stop air escaping through the nose, it is called velopharyngeal dysfunction, or VPD or VPI for short. So, why do children born with a cleft have more trouble with this valve system? Well, in an unrepaired cleft, there is a complete gap in the middle. So until the cleft is repaired, the child will have no control about air leaking out of the nose, and often even milk and other drinks will leak out while the child is drinking. The main purpose of the cleft palate repair surgery is to recreate that barrier and to reconstruct the soft palate in a way that results in a well-functioning valve system. But even after cleft palate repair, some children will have trouble with this valve system. A common problem after cleft palate surgery is that the palate is shortened from scarring. What this means is that even if the palate lifts nicely, it can't make contact with the back of the throat, and air escapes out of the nose. Another common problem is that the muscles are trying to work to lift the palate, but they don't have enough movement to get the palate as high as it needs to be to make contact, allowing air to escape above the palate. One of the most common problems is that as the child has grown since the time of the palate repair, the muscles have moved forward in the palate, so they're lifting the palate inefficiently and are unable to make contact, and air escapes through the nose. My job as a cleft speech surgeon is to reconstruct that valve system between the soft palate and the throat in a way that is most appropriate for each individual child, so that the child can close off air escaping through the nose and can make the speech sounds he or she is trying to make. In my next video, I will discuss how my speech team and I evaluate each child to determine whether surgery would be helpful and how to decide which type of speech surgery will be appropriate for each individual child. Thank you for watching, and if you would like any more information about me and my practice, please visit my website at www.drseaward.org.